Good evening, everyone. My name is Danny Orlean, and I am married to the Honorable Mayor Armstead. I would like to take this opportunity to thank everyone and to welcome everyone to our City of Linden Prayer Vigil. And we are gathered today because, you know, as human beings, whenever we see injustice in the world, we need to stand up and we need to do something. You know, if you don't do anything, you are part of the problem. So this is why we're gathered here today, to pray for peace in the world. And I have with me Josh Leal. Leal, he will be starting our ceremony. Thank you.
Josh, before you start, just let me say a few words.
Okay? Okay.
Just let the mayor say a few things.
Okay.
These days, like, I'll be 63 years old my next birthday, and I would like to have, I'd like to be able to say, one day I'll see a world where there's peace, peace on earth. I mean, God has blessed us with so much. We have more, we have all the water we can drink, we have so much air. He created an ecosystem that's just, I mean, it's amazing what he created here. And we got plenty of food, more food, enough food in the world to feed everybody. I'm trying to figure out, what the heck are we fighting for? It's enough for everybody. It just makes no sense. In theory, we could probably have heaven here on earth if we just learned to get along with each other and didn't fight. I mean, what is the purpose? Really, what is the purpose? I don't get it. You know, I had hoped, like I said, in my lifetime to see peace on earth, but now I find myself telling my children, probably won't happen in my lifetime, maybe in your lifetime, son or daughter, you know, but I just hope that one day people from all over the world can get together and feel and realize that God, in his infinite wisdom, created something here that's special. It really is special. And why are we just beating each other up, you know? There's no question, when I turned my TV on a couple of weeks ago and saw a terrorist going into Israel and killing and hurting, maiming innocent women and children. I mean, you know, me and my wife were watching TV and we saw this woman with her two children, looked like they were twins. It was gut-wrenching. And to that end, we know that the people who committed those atrocities were horrible people. Hamas is a dangerous organization. They don't care about life. But we have to be better. We have to be better. My heart hurts just as much for innocent Palestinian children who are caught up in this conflict, who don't care. They didn't ask for this. You know, we've got to figure out a way to get rid of those evil, hateful people, so we can go about living as human beings once again. And again, I don't think it's going to happen in my lifetime. I'm prayerful that it will be, but I'm at the point now at my age where I tell my children it probably won't happen in my lifetime. It's going to probably happen in their lifetime. So again, we're here today because we do believe there's power in prayer. I do believe that sometimes, even though we question God and the things that are going on our planet, I do believe that he still is there, and that somehow, some way, he'll touch hearts in a way that maybe there will be peace. And if he doesn't do it for any other reason, let's do it for those young people, the innocent people who are dying, who do not deserve what they're going through. So with that, I'll turn it over to the pastor.
Well, I want to thank all of you guys for joining us tonight and joining the mayor and his wife. Our hearts are really troubled with what we've been seeing and hearing, but we have hope. We have hope, and I want to read a scripture of encouragement for you guys, and I want to believe that the Lord is going to touch that part of the world and touch every people on both sides. I'm going to be reading from the book of Ephesians chapter 2, verse 14, and it says, "For he is our peace, who made both one and broke down the middle wall of hostility, having abolished it in his flesh, the enmity, even the law of condemnation that contained ordinances, that he might create in himself of two one new man, so making peace, and might reconcile both in one body unto God through the cross." Father God in heaven, we turn our attention to you, we turn our gaze to you in this day, in this hour, when so much ugly in the world is manifesting. And we turn to your people, Israel, and we turn to the neighbors of those surrounding Israel in this part of the world where hostility is taking place, where innocent lives are being killed on both sides due to the evil that has risen up in this group of Hamas. Lord, we ask right now for your peace to come. You told us that the promise of peace between two peoples and the nations of the earth would come in the form of your son, Jesus. He is our peace, and he is the one that breaks down the walls of hostility, the walls of enmity, the walls of strife. And so, Father, we are asking you right now to work in the hearts of men and women and children who are right now grieving, filled with pain over the atrocities, over the loss, over the saddened things that are taking place at the merciless hands of people who have given themselves over to wicked ideologies. And we ask you, Lord, to bring the peace that only you can bring. We ask you, Holy Spirit, to comfort and to touch every heart that has been impacted and continues to be impacted by the war that is taking place. Lord, we ask that you would rise up like a man of war, and that you would scatter your enemies, that you would expose all the tactics of those who are doing these evil deeds, that you would allow it to come to an end. And we pray that you would raise up support from all around the world, and even through your church, God, that would go and be ministers, your hands, your feet, to all those who are being punished in this, Lord, both Palestinians and Jews. Father, we ask that you would send reinforcements. We ask that you would send aid, and that we ask that you would send medical assistance and hospitals and doctors to be able to minister to those who are dealing with wounds because of the conflict in this area. But Lord, we pray that you would open up the eyes, even of people who have been led astray in deep darkness, like the organization of Hamas, that you would open up the eyes to see the man in white, that you would open up the eyes to see the one they've been warring against, that you would open up the eyes of this man of peace that we call Yeshua, the Messiah of that part of the world, and even all the other parts of the world. And you instructed us, God, according to your word, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And you said that you would bless those who pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Our desire is to see your purposes and your plan for the people of Israel, and by extension, all the nations that surround her. For it was told to us in the scriptures that you intend to bless the Gentile nations through Israel, who you call to be a light and a hope unto the nations, in pointing them to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And so we ask you, God, that you would move right now when we can't even believe for peace, that you would move mightily through the name of your son, that he would be the one that comes and breaks down all the barriers, all the hostility, all the enmity, all the strife that we see going on throughout the ages. Lord, we ask that you would do a work that we've not seen in our day. And we ask that it would take place through the spreading and the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the man of peace, the shepherd of peace, the one who said he is our peace, that you would take the two peoples that are right now in a place of hostility towards each other, and you would bring them one. Lord, that you would even help both the Palestinians and the Israelis to see that Hamas does not represent the vast majority of Palestinians, and it definitely doesn't represent those of the Jewish faith. Father, that they would both be able to see this enemy in place and to say, we're not going to fight each other, we're going to come together united. But Lord, we ask that you would help them, and that you would help them to see that they are brothers, and that they can hold hands in peace, that they can hold hands in understanding that your intention and your plan all along has been to bring the two men and make them one, Jew and Gentile, one in Messiah, one under the headship, the leadership of our Messiah Jesus. We pray all these things, and Father, we ask that you would continue to make Israel a praise on the earth. This is your plan. You said you would raise up watchmen on the wall. You would raise up intercessors, people who would pray for the peace of Jerusalem day and night. And so we are adding our prayers to the prayers that have gone before us for centuries ago and even to this day in faith, knowing that you are a God of covenant. You have said that your name will forever be in Israel, and you have said forever your name will be exalted and hallowed. So, Father, we contend and we believe for the opening of the eyes of the Jewish people, that you would heal their hearts, that you would heal their land, and you would help them see their Messiah. And by extension, you would help all the neighboring Arab groups and Palestinians to see the hope of glory as well. You would take the two men, the two people groups, and you would make them one new man in Messiah, and that you would bring peace, and it would go to the nations. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Okay, I would like to ask Pastor Overton.
God bless you all for coming here on this evening. And I felt moved. I came here in Uber because I thought it was that important for Manville, New Jersey, to come here and pray. Because we are in a time that we really, if we never needed God, we surely need him now. And it's time for God's children, all of us, to not fight about religion, but have relationship with him. It doesn't matter how you want to pray, as long as you're praying. If you're not serving the devil, then we're okay with that. So we all need to come together as a people, as one body, the Jews, the Gentiles, the Christians, the Muslims, everyone come together and pray and seek the face of God like never before. And I wanted to read this scripture. It's coming from the King James Version of the Holy Bible. And 2 Chronicles 7 and 14 says, if my people, which are called upon my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and will heal their land. Our land and our nation is in trouble all over the world. And we can't get to the real issues at hand because we're too busy fighting each other over things that are a distraction to us. Things that are going on in the world. I'm not going to preach because I feel the baddest, you know, Christian preaching thing coming on here. But I just want to say that if we focus on God and stop the fighting each other here Here in America, we got to stop fighting each other. It's too much fighting for years and years and years. That's why things are keep happening. The Bible, though, it does not lie. We're in the end time now. These things will happen. It says it in the Word, the Holy Quran, the Bible, that it's going to come a time there's wars and rumors of wars. All of these things must come together and happen before the fulfillment for Christ's return. So we have to pray. Really pray, because it's getting bad. I saw the key points of prayer that the Mr. Mayor put on there, and it wasn't just Israel, different things. Our children are in trouble with social media, and our children are in trouble. Sex trafficking, all things right here in the United States, things that happen. Children are missing, and they're suicidal, 8 and 9, 10 years old, want to take their lives. We are in trouble. We have to turn to God for answers. Amen. So I'm going to pray now. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I come right now your humble servant, asking you, Lord, to speak through me right now in the name of Jesus. Speak through me, Lord, and touch those that are listening all over, wherever they're tuning in from, God. We need you, Lord, like never before. And we asking you, Lord, to come down and touch our land. We repent, Father, to you for things that we've done against you, Lord. Against you we have sinned. We repent now as a land, as a nation, and as a world for things that we've done that is not pleasing in your sight, God. We need you, Father God, to come in and heal us now. Go to Israel right now, God. Just like there was peace to the storm in your word when the storm was raging and you just came, you were asleep. Your son Jesus was asleep in the bottom of the boat. Just like then, look, you said, peace, O ye little faith, peace, and everything had to obey your will, Lord. Everything had to obey your voice, Lord God. Peace. So we speak peace to Israel right now. Speak peace, Lord. We calling and crying on you, God. Peace to the land, Lord. We send your spirit of peace right now, oh God. Nothing can change unless you change it, Lord. Oh God, we pray right now, even in America, oh God, that there will be unity, oh God, with everyone, God. Not religion, Lord, but relationship. Call your people together to humble themselves, oh God, and seek your face and turn from their wicked ways and stop fighting about religion and you're wrong, this one is right. We gotta pray this way. This is wrong, you're wrong because you serve Jesus. Have mercy on us, oh God, for being distracted, and let us get to the real priority at hand, God. In the name of Jesus, we asking you, Lord, to look over government, God. We thank you right now for using Mr. Mayor, oh God. You said in your word that the government, Lord, is upon your shoulders, Lord. Oh God, they have to come to you for everything, Lord. We repent right now. We repent for taking prayer out of the schools, Lord. We repent right now, oh God. Have mercy on us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We call your people together, Lord. All nations, all religions, all ethnicities, we calling on you right now for peace, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Peace, God, even with religions, oh God, we come against now and we rebuke those doctrines, Lord. Oh, have mercy on us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let us unify together. Let us all come together as one, Lord, in the name of Jesus. So all the war, all the hatred, you are God of love and peace. Love and peace. Oh God, we thank you for you, God of love. And though that worship you must worship you in spirit and in truth, God, we thank you today. Oh, tonight, God, we're calling on you. We thank you for even allowing this, oh God, allowing this time to even call on you, Jesus. Even the ones that are the sound of my voice right now that can hear me, God, that we come against depression of the mind. We come against depression, oh God, suicide. Oh God, ones that want to give up on themselves, oh God. We unite families together that are broken, Lord. Families that are not talking to each other. All kind of nonsense is going on. Lord Jesus, oh God, come. We need your mercy and we need your grace right now, Father. Oh God, look over the children that are missing, Lord. They are out there sex trafficking, oh God. Oh God, we pray right now, Lord, that they will be found alive and well, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, have your way in this land. Have your way in this nation, God. We say thank you. We give you the glory. We thank you for the victory. We thank you for the praise reports of things that's going to happen, Lord. Peace right now in Israel. Peace. peace right now, God. Nothing can happen unless you do it. We don't have no miracle prayers. We have to come to you, Lord. And when the peace happens, Reverend Overton can't get the credit. You get the credit and the glory for the peace happening and being still in the land. Lord, we say thank you. Lord, we say thank you. We thank you for the victory. And we pray right now. We seal this prayer with the blood of Jesus. Protect everybody on the sound of my voice, Lord. We come against backlash and retaliation. Anyway, you are defeated. You were defeated on Calvary, and you have lost again because the people of God are united together again. They are united, oh God. So Satan, you lose again. We thank you right now, God. We give you the glory now. Seal this prayer. Cover everyone under the sound of my voice with your angels. Send them with protection. Cover. Let no hurt, harm, or danger come nigh the dwelling, oh God, of anybody that's involved with this, Lord. We say thank you and we praise you and we seal this prayer with the blood of Jesus. Yahweh, Yeshua Mashiach, we thank you right now, God. We thank you, oh God, in the name of Allah. We thank you, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I think I covered all religion. Hail Mary, full of grace. If you're here, Catholic people, blessings of the womb and the fruit of thy womb, Jesus, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen. Thank God and amen.
At this time, before we end, I would like to take a moment's silence for the people of Israel, for the people that are still being held hostage. You know, let's give them about 30 seconds of silence.
Thank you.
everybody. Thank you all for coming out. We appreciate it. Thank you all.
Thanks for arguing with you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.